Hello, brethren. Welcome to today's Bible study session. Today's topic is about the way of salvation. Salvation. How can we be saved? What is the way of salvation? That is what we are going to find out today. To begin with, I am going to read from the book of John chapter 14, 6. According to the New King James Version, it is written, Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father, but by me. In this Bible verse, Jesus answered Thomas when Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? He told him, He is the way. Christ is not merely the way, as he goes before his people as an example or merely as a prophet, pointing out unto them by his doctrine the way of salvation, but he is a way of salvation itself by his obedience and sacrifice. Nor is there any other. He is the way of his Father's appointing, and which is entirely agreeable to the perfections of God, and suitable to the case and condition of sinners. He also answered that he is the truth. This means he is not only true but truth itself. He is the true God, and eternal life. Truly and really a man. As a prophet, he taught the way of God in truth. He also said he is the life. This means Christ is the author and giver of life. Natural, spiritual, and eternal, or he is the way of life, or the living way. Christ is the true way to eternal life. It is added by way of explanation of him, as the way. The second reading comes from the book of Acts chapter 16 verse 31. In the King James Version Bible, it is written, And they said, Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house. These are the words of Paul and Silas. They answered the prison guard when he asked them what he must do to be saved. According to the scripture, we realize that, in order to be saved, together with our household, we need to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, for he is the way of salvation. Everyone in your household should believe in our Lord Jesus Christ in order to be saved. Really wonderful words, brethren. Please someone to read for us our third scripture. That is from the book of Romans chapter 10 verse 9.
I am going to read from the New King James Version. It is written, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved.
Thank you. In the verse, Paul's heart is broken for his people, Israel. He prays they will be saved through faith in Christ. Their enthusiasm for God is made useless by their attempt to be made righteous by their own law-keeping instead of by faith in Christ. What, then, is required to be saved? One must confess that Jesus is Lord and believe that God raised him from the dead. That is true. If we do this, brethren, and if our household does this, we shall be saved. That's it for today, brethren. I hope everyone listening to this Bible study has learned something and now you know the way of salvation. Stay safe. See you in our next Bible study session. Be blessed.